Hello friends, today we will look at the magnetism, the effect of magnetism and also the magnetic field of a magnet. So let us begin with a magnetic compass. You may have seen such a device. So for this experiment, I am using the material from this experiment toolkit. It's called Hello Magnet, and it is from a company called Kutuhal. It's a company from Pune, and you can buy it from Amazon. So there are a lot of different types of magnets and also other material that can be used for making experiments to learn the properties of magnet. There is also a booklet with this kit. So I will be using some of the material from this kit, and also I have some extra material that I can show you. So let us see how this magnetic compass works. The magnetic compass helps you to find which direction is where, as the earth rotates from west towards east. That is, this is the rotation of earth. Therefore, we see sun is rising from the east. Actually, we are going from west to east. The surface of earth is rotating like this. It's about 460 meters per second. We are in a rotation around the earth's axis. So from where I am sitting, I am facing north. This is the north direction, and east is to the right hand of my side. So I will place this magnetic compass so that it matches the east-west direction, and after that you can move this compass so that it aligns to the north. This needle is magnetic, so it will always point the towards north-south. The red pointer of this compass will be pointing towards north, and the other end towards the south. So this is called the magnetic north, and this is called the magnetic south. Magnetic compasses were used on ships to find which direction they are going. The sailors used to use this device. So this device also comes with that kit. You can find one magnetic compass in the kit that I just showed you. So here is a powerful magnet I have purchased. It's not part of that kit, I have purchased it separately. It's quite powerful. As you can see, as I hold this magnet nearby, you can notice the movement of the pointer of the compass. So as we know that the red point to the north. So if we can attract the north, it means this is the south pole of our magnet. And if we reverse it, then we will be repulsing the north. The red pointer is being repulsed, means this is the north and this is the south. So you can use a magnetic compass to find out the polarity of your magnet. If your magnet is unmarked, if it is not marked which is south and which is north, then you can use a magnetic compass like this to find out. So the red pointer of this compass is being attracted to this face. It means this is south and the other one is north. So let us use a marker to just color this surface so that we can recognize that this is the north of this magnet. So let us place this magnet on the table, and let us use this magnetic compass. This is the north, so the red pointer is pointing away from this magnet. So this is the field of influence of this magnet, and then as we move, As you can see, this is the magnetic field. The magnetic field goes from north to south. So using a compass, you can determine the field lines of a magnet. So just place it near the north and then try to find out how far the magnetic needle moves, reacts to the magnetic field. As you can see, the needle moves this way, like this. So from north to south, this is the direction of the magnetic field. Again, from the other side, we can try it. We can move it like this. So this is how the magnetic field, the direction of the magnetic field is from north to south. We can also do the iron filling experiment to look at the pattern that a magnet creates. Let us place a transparent sheet above the magnet and we can put some iron fillings over the magnet. So as you can see, this is the pattern that the magnet creates. So that is the magnetic field, and we can look at the two-dimensional view. Actually, when you hold a magnet, the magnetic field surrounds the magnet. So it is a three-dimensional field. In the same way, our Earth also has a magnetic field. The magnetic field surrounds the entire Earth. This is the globe, and if you look at the direction here, this is the north, this is south, this is east, and this is west. And the earth is little bit tilted like this, so our earth will be actually in this position in the and let us say sun is to this direction, and actually our earth is moving this way from west to east. So this is the actual rotation of our earth in the space. So this is how, see, Japan goes to the east first, and then slowly we are moving to westwards. So what happens? There is a magnetic field surrounding our earth like this. It's a huge magnetic field. So the solar winds come from the sun towards our earth. So what happens? The magnetic field stops that solar wind, and because of the solar wind, the magnetic field is bended like this. The magnetic field will be less in this direction, and then it will move this way. So the magnetic field blocks a lot of harmful rays reaching to Earth. That's how the life on Earth is protected. So the area around the Earth protected by the magnetic field is called magnetosphere. You may have also heard that A few days ago, the Voyager 2 spacecraft crossed the heliosphere. So as we saw the magnetosphere around the Earth, there is also a sphere of the Sun. So that is called heliosphere. Out of heliosphere, there are the stellar winds coming from the outer cosmos in the Sun's heliosphere. So as there is a magnetosphere around the Earth, there is a heliosphere around the Sun, and it also functions almost the same way as the magnetosphere of Earth functions. So the stellar winds coming towards the Sun, they are blocked by the Sun's heliosphere. The area where it is blocked is called heliopause. So the Voyager 2 has crossed the heliopause and entered into the interstellar space. It took almost 35 years. So now you know how the magnetic compass work and how you can determine the polarity of a magnet, and also how the magnetic field is created around a magnet and also around the Earth. So if you want to use a compass, then you should be sure that it is working right. As you see, if you look at this compass, the red marking on the pointer is pointing towards the north. And now look at this compass, it is pointing just opposite. So this is a problem that happens to this type of magnetic compasses. If you place this type of compass anywhere near a metallic object, let's say for 15 days or more, then this kind of polarity reversal happens to this compass. So if you find that your compass has reversed the polarity, you can easily correct it. I will show you how to do that. For that, we will need a powerful magnet like this. So what we will do, we will reverse the polarity of this magnetic needle. Just hold the magnet near the polarity and then swipe it like this. Now you can see within a few swipes, the polarity is reversed. So in case if your magnetic compass has changed the polarity, then swipe the magnet over the needle. So it will reverse its polarity. So I hope this is helpful for you. So that's it for today. Let us see some more interesting things in the next video.